Hi everyone, you're welcome back to your Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we are going to talk about how to have access to your device camera. So if it's an iOS or Android, how can you have access to the camera? How can you take images? How can you also add or select already captured images into your application by using an interface on API that is known as an iMedia Picker? I've already made a video on using File Picker, which allows you to select files, PDF, videos, audios, images from your device. And this one, that's the Media Picker, also going to allow you to take or capture images, videos, taking videos, and also taking images as well. So let's have a look with this. Now, what you have to do here is you have to create a new project. Now, after we are done with this, I'm going to put this at the GitHub. So I'll put a link at the description. So check it over there and you can get the code if you want to review what you've done again. So let's create a new project. We have a nice project created. Now let's see. So in order to use this, let's go to the main page because that is where you want to use this Media Picker. So we click on the main page. Now let's work on the main page or XML.cs. That is the code behind file. You see, we have this button. So let's comment this. So Control K, C, you comment this one. And now in here, before we do this, we have to enable some permissions. So before you write anything here, let's go back to the Android manifest. So click on platform Android, then Android manifest. So right click on this and let's go to open with, then choose XML editor. So we have to add some permissions here to have access to the camera. So what is the permission that you have to add? Let's have to grab one of these. And now in here, instead of the camera, we're going to say camera. We make sure they are in caps. So you want to have access to camera and also you want to read external storage. So let's make a copy of this. Let's paste it again. So here, aside from camera, we want to read external storage. So read, then we have external storage. Then, aside from reading external storage, you want to also write. So write external storage. Okay, so after reading and writing, we want to read media videos and also read media audio and images. So let's add one to this. Let's add two more. So here you want to read media audio, then you want to read media images. So read media images, and the last one you can read video. So read media video. Okay, so we now have permissions that we want or we need. Then this is what we are going to do. Let's save this and now let's start using the code. that is the interface or the API. Now you see we have the button here. Now when you go to the example file, you see we have this button, and that's what you are issuing the command. So as soon as I click on this button, what should happen? That is the next thing to do. So in here, we can now have access to some APIs such as pick picture or pick photo async, capture photo async for capturing or using the camera, also pick video, and also capture video. So you know you can have access to pick and capture. Capture means it's going to use the camera to take it, but for pick it means it has already been captured and you're going to just grab the file and insert it. Let's have a look first with how to take in a photo. So in this button, let's write here, so take photo. Or capture photo. So this is what you're going to do. So let's use media picker dot default dot is captured supported. So if the device is support capturing, then this is what you're going to do. Else, maybe we can just say await cell dot current dot display an alert. So you can just write something like, oops, your device so isn't supported. Then you can just have a cancel button of okay. But in case it supports, then you want to use it. So let's say you want to have file results, then we can say my photo is equal to, you can have an await. Then let's use this media picker dot default. Then here we have all the interface that we can use. Because we have pick photo async, capture photo async. So we go to this capture. So this is going to allow us to capture image. So after capturing, we can just check. So if image is not now, then this is what you're going to do. Let's save the photo inside our application. So we're going to say, so let me give it a title here. So save the image captured in the application. So down here, we can now say string local file path is equal to, you can now have in path.combine, then file system. So file system.cached directory. Then you want to place my photo over there. So you want to just store the name. So that is my photo dot file name. You know this, you can have access to the following details or data from the image that we captured. As soon as I click on dot, you see we have full name, we have file name. Okay, so you can have, we have the full path and the file name. So if you want to have the full path where you captured the image from, you're going to have it over there. And you want to use the file name. All right, so after storing this, we want to display maybe this image. So we're going to talk about using stream. You can say source stream is equal to await. Then we can now have photo dot read async. So you don't want to have this photo open read, so you want to do photo dot read async first. So this is going to be my photo. So dot read async. So after reading this, we're going to convert this into bytes. Then we are going to use the next using file stream, and we say local file stream is equal to file dot open write. Now that you put in the path, that's a local file path. Okay, this local file path is referring to this. You know, this here, it is putting the file inside the file system, and I think that's going to be the resources folder. We have a folder also called raw folder. This, I believe, this is where we're going to have the image. Let's see, when we capture an image, let's see where it's going to go. Now, aside from this, the last one that you have to do is await. Now you're passing the source stream dot copy to. So now you're not going to copy to async, then copy the local file stream. Okay, so that is this. Now let's save this one and let's run it in Windows first and see what's going to happen as soon as you click on that button. All right, so we have the app launched, and that is the window. So let's click on Click Me. And as soon as we click on this button, let's see what's going to happen. So, you know, when I click on this button, nothing happened because this desktop that I'm using here doesn't support camera. So you see, that is why it is not displaying anything. But let's see, let's stop this and now let's run this in Android and let's see if you can have access to the device camera. So I'm going to choose framework, then Android, and now let's run it on Android. So click on this, the emulator. That is a 12.0 API of 31. And now let's wait for it to pop up in the Android, and we see. So the app is ready. Now if I click on this button, let's see, so click me. And now let's have access. So you see, it's asking you allow demo picker to take picture and record video. So as you can see, while using that app only this time. So if I click on this, then it's going to have access to the device camera. As you can see from here, so as having access to our device camera over here. But as you can see, we have an exception because it is saying that either the, let's say, it is saying Microsoft.Maui application model dot feature not supported exception. So either there was no camera on the device, or this Android media dot actions image capture was not added to the queries element in the app's manifest file. So I mean, we have to also additionally add one permission. Okay, so let's see. Now let's go back to the Solution Explorer. So let's close this. Now, Solution Explorer, the same platform. So we go to manifest Android. And now I think we've opened it already. So it is asking us to add permission here. So now in here, let's have these queries added. And inside these queries, you must have an intent. And inside this intent, you must have an action. So this action, we say it is for Android. The name of this action is equal to, we're going to have Android dot media dot action dot image capture. Let's close this. Control KD, we format it well, and that is all that we need to do here. Very simple. Now let's run this application and see. So now let's click on the button. Click me button. So click on it. And now let's, you can see we have camera here popped up. And it is saying that entering camera mode. So got it. And you can see we can now use our camera to take an image. So as soon as I click on capture, then we're going to capture the image. As you can see from here, that's the image that has been captured. Yeah, so you can see that our camera assessing is working. We can use camera to take image or also record video. So with this, what I'm going to do, if you want to record video too, then what I'm going to do, let's see. So the same stage where we went, instead of using this, the capture photo async, if it's a video that I want to do, you can just use record video. Now, aside from this, let's see. So I'm going to just grab this. So I'll just copy this and I'll paste this like that. So let me just copy this comment and I'll put it on top here. So the first one is to capture image. And now the second one here is to load image. So load photo. So load photo. So that's already captured image. Now with this, let's comment this one. And now here, instead of the capture photo async, we're going to use dot pick. So pick photo async. So we can now save this. And now let's run this again. And now let's see what we can do as soon as I click on this button. So let's click on the button. Now we're going to select a captured image or photo already. So as soon as I click on click me, then you can see that it has opened our file system here. You know, since we are using an emulator, that is why we are not having image here. But when you use the real one, when you test it on the real phone, you're going to have all your media over here. And now you can just go in there and I'll pick image. Let's find this in Android 2 and see. So I'm going to close this. That is a Windows. So, and now let's choose Windows. We couldn't use the capture photo async with the Windows. Now let's try if pick photo async going to work here. And I'm sure this is going to work. So now let's click on the button. And as you can see, we have here that we can choose an image from. So if I go to image, I can just now pick an image. So open it. And the image is now selected. Let's see if we can have the image somewhere in the application. So the image that we selected has now copied to the cache. Now, to see this, let's add one line of command so we can have access to the cache location. So let's copy this. And now let's paste it here. So as soon as we finish downloading, we want to display the current file location. So we can now have access to this file stream. Then, so we can have the name from this. So let's pass a name here. Now let's run this or let's refresh this. And you're going to select an image. It's going to pop up and tell us exactly where the file is located. And we're going to trace to that folder to see if the file is there. So clicking me to select an image and I'm going to choose this. So click on open and then that's the location. So you see we have this location here. So now let's trace to this. Now if I open my folder, we have this as 66 and let me go back here. If that is what, so I'm look at cache, then is that the bookend? So let's choose a different image here and see. So see, we have the booking, we have the image here. Now I can just choose this contact, open this. Now you see this is the contact. As soon as I click on OK, you have the contact image here. So that is a way to use a media picker to just get files or take images or snap images or take videos as well. Okay, thank you so much for watching. I believe this is going to help you. Yeah. And I'm going to catch you up in the next video.